Whenever you're on the Scott Van Pelt show and you have hair, Scott ends up talking about hair. And you're talking about maybe going to a salon. And not only that, you're talking about a ponytail. So have those things happened? Have you started going to a salon? And it surprises me with a country boy like you would go to a salon. But is that a step that you took?
Well, I've got a girl here in town named Kathy. She does a great job cutting my hair. She's actually in a salon. I tried the ponytail out at the house. I tied it up in the back a few months ago, and my 13-year-old, he panicked. He was afraid that his friends would see it, so I haven't gone back to that. Kind of using that as leverage, if he doesn't do well in school, that I might fire the ponytail back up and actually wear it in public.
You'll have an A student, you do that, you got that threat hanging over his head. There's no doubt about that. Any kid's nightmare would be their father in a ponytail. One of the interesting things of being a coach is having to go into a young person's house and recruit him. You do it all the time. I did it in junior hockey. You're talking with 16, 17, 18-year-old kids, pimples on their face. Do you have a story, a good story of you walking into some kid's house and recruiting them?
It never fails that I'll have a parent or a grandparent that'll come into the room and they'll recognize me based on long hair, could be based on the rant.
Come after me! I'm a man! I'm 40! I'm not a kid!
We'll have a conversation that doesn't have anything to do with football. And when we've had those conversations and I've been in that setting, in most cases, we end up getting the young man.
One of the great pictures that I saw of you, and I got a big chuckle out of it, getting to know you a little bit over the last couple of years, is a Midnight Madness, and you got the shirt off, and you're swinging the shirt over your head, and you're trying to get all the other people involved and cheering for the basketball team. So is that something that when you're recruiting a kid, you walk into a house, they might have seen that picture on YouTube or around the country?
In the incident where I took my shirt off, I couldn't get Mason Rudolph, who is a big, good-looking 6'4", 230-pound guy to take his shirt off. He was too shy, so I had to lead the way and to lure him into doing that by taking mine off. But we had a lot of fun with that, and we get a great response from the young men that we're recruiting. And that's what it's all about.
Well, Steve Levy, the guy that's hosting this show with me, co-hosting this show with me, has sort of turned into a pseudo football expert. And Mr. Levy, he's done two of your games. You've lost both of those games. So I would maybe think about talking about him not being allowed to do any more of your games. He's obviously a guy that brings your program down.
Well, we got to get him in here when we're playing again. We got to get that corrected really fast. We need to get Levy down here, and we need to have another game, and he'll find that we can win a football game while he's doing the commentating or the color.